He's a great kid, you know. He deserves better.
Welcome back,
and
guys.
What about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
I feel sort of anesthetized, as if none of this was real. Sometimes I tell myself this whole thing is just a nightmare and that I'll wake up at any moment.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
I sometimes have these blackouts. Times when I don't know what I'm doing. I recover consciousness sometime later, but I'm someplace else. And I have no idea how I got there. Do you think this could be related to the accident?
You suffered a massive concussion and were in a coma for 6 months. We really don't know what effect a shock like that can have on the brain. That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation next week. You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor. Aren't you gonna go play with the other kids?
I don't feel like it.
Is something the matter, Sean?
No, I'm all right.
Do you want to eat something? How did things go at school today?
I was punished because I didn't do my homework.
Aww.
I'm sorry about that, Sean. Next time, we'll really pull it together, okay?
Aw, man, I'm such a bad father, Nicholas.
A boomerang? You know how to use it?
No, not really. I can never make it come back.
Can I give it a try?
You did it, Dad!
Do you want to give it a try?
I'll be able to do it.
Come on, let's try it together. Now, the main thing is to get the right position at the beginning.
Now you gotta throw it straight and a little to the right.
Good job, Sean.
See? That wasn't so hard.
Oh.
I'll find something else to do with him.
I have been on a seesaw in a long time.
What do you think?
Yeah!
What about that merry-go-round? I bet I can push it so fast you won't be able to stay on.
Great!
I will go so fast that you won't be able to hold on to the little kid.
Faster! Come on! Whoa! My head is spinning.
Good training for astronauts, though.
You wanna go play on the swing? I'll push you.
Okay. That was cool.
I'd like a packet of strawberry flavored chewies, please. Thanks. Hey, I got you some chewies.
I hate strawberries. Thanks. It was nice of you anyway.
Man, can't believe it. I gave myself the wrong food. Can I make the airplane thing?
Looks like rain's coming.
I think we better go.
Okay.
You know, sometimes I remember before. I mean, when Jason was still here. Sometimes I wish everything could just be the way it was before.
Me too, Sean. Me too.
Hey, Dad, can I have a ride on the carousel? Can I?
Sure. Go pick a horse and get on. I'll get a ticket. One, please.
That's a dollar.
I lost Sean! My horrible father.
How do I keep unlocking a bonus for every time? What? Unlocked a bonus. Okay, strange. How do I keep unlocking these? Was I just taking a chill?
Do Do you think it's gonna take long?
No, he should be finished soon.
I'll look at the reports later. Cancel all appointments for this afternoon.
Okay. Oh, Captain. Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is here.
Hey, you're checking my TV.
And I feel fine.
Jaden, of course. I've been expecting you. I'm in a bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course. I wanted to introduce myself before getting started, but perhaps there's a better time.
No, it's fine. Just have to get We have them every day now. Believe me, it's not always easy finding something to tell them. Fortunately, today we have some news.
I should put AC/DC on.
Have you met
Thunder?
Lieutenant Blake yet?
And record outside while he's playing, then put it on Facebook.
He has his own methods, but he's a good cop. I'm sure you'll get him. You know how to tie a knot in a necktie.
Well, I redid the
I guess.
I hope I fixed the window.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI on this one, but the press are all over us. This origami killer case crept up on us, and it's fast becoming a national concern. There are hundreds of killers in this country, but what do you know? This guy is exotic. He's flowers and origami figures. Work that one out. Then the press get onto it, and we suddenly become the center of the universe.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it, it's none of my business.
No, of course not. All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator, and we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter. Not bad.
Oh, go see Charlene. She'll show you to your office. Yeah, check in on the press conference if you're interested. It'll give you an idea of the political climate around here.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to the club, Jaden.
Suggests the methodology of the origami killer. The investigation should confirm this in the coming days. The police are continuing to work around the clock to find the murderer as quickly as possible. I'll field some questions. Yes.
You said the methodology indicated another victim for the origami killer. Can you be more specific?
An origami figure was found in the victim's hand, and an orchid was placed on his chest. His face was covered with mud, but there were no visible traces of violence in the body. Go ahead.
The Zodiac killer was never identified. Perhaps the origami killer will never be found either.
I don't think there's much chance of that. For the moment, the killer may think he's invulnerable, but in the end he'll make a mistake and we'll be there to arrest him. Yes?
Did the killer leave any written evidence? Perhaps a ransom note explaining his actions? Or anything like that?
No. He has not made contact in any way, and we have only the murders to help us understand his motives. Yes. What's the question?
Some people are saying that the police were slow to take an interest in these murders because the victims lived in poorer parts of the city. What do you say to that?
That's absurd. The police make no distinctions between victims based on their social class. It is true that the origami killer seems to choose his victims from the more impoverished parts of town. The higher crime rate in these areas makes the investigation more difficult. Time for a couple more. Yes.
There are rumors that the FBI has sent a profiler to help with the investigation. Is that true?
You seem to be well informed. Yes, we asked the FBI to send us a profiler to help us with this investigation. We were planning to announce this in the next few days, but it seems that won't be necessary.
According to certain sources, the town hall's been applying pressure to avoid any mention of a serial killer in order not to have an adverse effect on the mayor's election campaign. Do you have anything to say about that?
Pure speculation. At no time has the mayor been involved in this investigation, except to support the efforts of the police force, of course. Thank you for your cooperation.
One question, please, sir. One last question.
Captain Perry, one more question, please.
Nice watch.
Oh, it's the present we offer to our new lieutenants. We bought the same model each year for the past 20 years for each promotion. It optimizes everybody's time, and it's the kind of thing that always goes down well. You can contribute to our fund if you like. We're still a few dollars short.
Congratulate Larry on my behalf.
I'll be sure to do that, sir.
Captain Perry said you could show me to my office?
Yes, of course. Follow me.
This? This is my office?
That's where I was told to take you. If you need anything, you know where to find me.
Now, this is a crappy office, if I say so.
Okay, time to work. Step one. Change the office. Well, well. Looks like there's something new. Harry, comment. Tire tracks on the side of the road behind the railroad line. It may be the killer's car. His car is probably a Chevrolet Malibu 83. A common species. That doesn't help much.
This map is coming together.
Good.
No prints or specific clues. Nothing much to go on. Just one origami store in town.
I think I like this one. I like the movie.
Eight victims in the last 3 years. All boys, aged between 9 and 13. No signs of violence. The victims disappear from public places in broad daylight. No one notices anything. Bodies are found 3 to 5 days later, drowned in rainwater. Always the same ritual. An origami in the hand, an orchid on the chest. The victims have always been dead for less than 6 hours when they were found, which means they remained alive for several days before being drowned. Over 3,500 people questioned. Over 100 suspects interrogated. not a single lead to go on. Killer has a large comfort zone. He gained confidence rapidly and moved away from his base. This won't make the geoprofiling any easier. I need to take some. I'm gonna faint if I resist. That's all right. I know I can make it. I know I can make it.
Is everything all right, sir?
This is Lieutenant Blake, Mr. Marshall. Could you please tell him what happened?
It was this afternoon. I went to the park with my son, Sean. We played together for a while, and then he wanted to go on the carousel, so I put him on one of the wooden horses, and when I turned back, Sean had disappeared.
Exactly what time did you arrive at the park? Try to remember exactly, Mr. Mars. Every detail can be important.
It must have been about... ...5:30, I think. I'm not really sure.
What was your son wearing when he disappeared?
He was wearing a coat. A beige coat. And a pair of pants. Brown pants.
How could Sean have disappeared without you even noticing? Weren't you right by the carousel?
I went to sit on a bench a little way off. I didn't notice right away the carousel had stopped. That must have been when Sean disappeared.
You say you took your son to the park after school, but you didn't report him missing until 8:15. Why did it take you so long to contact the police?
I searched the whole neighborhood for him. I thought he couldn't have gone far.
Did Sean have any particular difficulties, Mr. Mars? Anything that might have caused him to run away?
Sean is a sensitive child. Our relationship has been a little difficult recently.
Everything okay at school?
Nathan, I need to sign this card. It's
so I can send it to Cousin Sherry.
I don't need anything hard.
I need you to sign this card.
I don't need anything hard to write it on.
Yes, here. Write nice under Pearl. No, wait. Do it nicely under Pearl. Don't make it about the same as her is. Go nicely. Slow down. I want it to be nice.
Any particular problems between you and your wife?
My wife and I have been separated for the last 6 months. But Sean would not have gone off without telling his mother or me.
All right. That's all the questions I have for now. You're free to go, Mr. Mars. We'll continue to look for Sean overnight. We'll contact you if we have any more questions.
Do you think the Origami Killer...
Listen, your son's probably just run off and he'll turn up in a couple of hours.
But what if it is the Origami Killer?
Well, then we have about 4 days to find him alive.
Did they find something?
No, nothing yet. But they're going to keep looking through the night.
Do they think it's the origami killer?
It's still too early to say. But it is a possibility.
What happened to Ethan? How could you lose Sean like that? You should never have taken your eyes off him. I mean, for God's sake, how hard is it to keep your eye on a child in the park? Why did you leave him, Ethan? Why? Wasn't it enough losing Jason? I'm sorry. It's not what I meant to say.
Good evening to you, sir.
Can I help you, sir?
Well, I hope so. My name's Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Origami Killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
My son is dead, Mr. Shelby. I have nothing more to say.
I also lost someone I loved. I know what you're feeling.
Then you will understand that I do not wish to talk about it.
The killer has kidnapped another victim. A 10-year-old boy. Like your son, Risa, I have 4 days before we find his body on a deserted stretch of wasteland.
No one did anything to save my son. Now, you would please to move along, sir.
Oh, do you sell inhalers? I'm all out, at least I won't go away completely empty-handed.
In the back of this door, to the right.
Thanks.
Wait a minute.
Good evening, sir. Are you looking for something in particular?
Give me what you got in the register. Don't fucking try anything. Open the register, you dumb fuck. Put the money on the counter. Shit, are you deaf or what? Are you gonna open that fucking register or not?
No, sir. You do not have the right to steal that money from me. I have worked very hard to earn it. You cannot have it.
What did you say? You're out of your fucking mind, man. You don't get it, do you? I'm gonna put a fucking bullet right between your eyes if you don't do what I say now.
Shit.
Hey, you! Come here! I said, come here now! Don't move! Hands up! Put your fucking hands up or I'll shoot!
Don't panic, let's just stay calm. Nobody here wants to hurt you. We're all just gonna be cool, and everything will be all right.
Yeah, yeah. I'm cool, man. Everything's gonna be all fucking right.
Look, it's not worth it. Put the gun down and just walk away.
You giving me advice? I'll give you some fucking advice.
You don't really want to shoot anybody, do you? I'm sure we can find a way out of this mess, right? My name's Scott. What about you? What's your name?
Andrew. My name's Andrew.
Do you have anyone you care for in your life? A girlfriend, maybe? A family?
Yeah. A little girl. I got a little girl. Her name is Jessica.
What would Jessica think if she saw you here? Ask yourself. What would happen to her if things go wrong? Now, I want you to put the gun back in your pocket and quietly walk out of the store. My friend and I will forget about what just happened, and you'll have earned a second chance not to fuck up your life. What do you say?
Thousand thank you, sir. I don't know what would have happened if you had not been here.
Well, this I didn't come by for nothing. Have a nice day.
When my boy, Razor, disappeared, I received a letter with a locker ticket inside. Inside the locker, I found this box. I do not understand what it means, but I think it must be a sort of message from the man who took my son from me.
Can I?
Please, take the box if it can be of any use to you at all. It did not help me to save Razor, but maybe it will help you find the other little boy. Mr. Shelby, I was beginning to think that there was no good to be found in this place. I can see now that I was wrong.
Josh, you still there, man?
Yeah, I'm still here.
Say hi to YouTube.
No.
Oh, okay. Ben.
sad. I live all alone. I thought I was gonna die by that guy. Underwear, really? Well, you can tell by the way I'm in my underwear. Well, I'm a man's man. No time to talk. There's a lock on my door. I don't want to open it. No, no, no. Whoa. That's gonna be hot tea. Why is she drinking that like non-stop, man? I'm a teaholic. Where's that coffee? What is this? Is this water? Is that water? Or is it not water? Why don't you find some clothes for my character? I don't like walking around in a tank top and underwear. Maybe I can look at some magazines. Well, this article says that there's somebody watching me? Oh, interesting article. Nice, all together. Nice. Somebody was watching me from over here. Who did that? Who can it be now? Hey! I found some clothes, and I can't put clothes on. I'm walking around in my underwear. This isn't good. This is not good. Why? This isn't good. Stop staring out the window. There's somebody could be behind you. Close the door. It's okay. What's this? What the? See, here's the bed. I can't do anything. Oh, I can. Nope. Gotta make sure everything's okay. Am I right, Josh, or am I right? Am I right, lad? Oh. Scared me. Welcome to the bathroom. Wow, this is a weird bathroom. I thought she was gonna look in the mirror, Josh, and just go, "Aw, no, please not." Oh my gosh. Why? Y'all don't wanna see what tell she took the pants back on. Gee, that was Yep. The reason why I did that is because I respect the women's privacy, so I didn't wanna. What am I doing? No! What did I just do? Bad driver? What? Let me look in the mirror. Look at my beautiful face. Touch. It's a little awkward playing as a woman in these games, but some games it's fine. Because your character is amazing. I do not. Oh, good. No. Are you serious? So I'm just censoring this out. Unless y'all want to see some of that. respect. Oh my gosh. Respect. I had to do something. It told me to press the arrow key. Not the arrow key, the arrow. Wow, respect. Something. Oh my gosh. Put some clothes back on. Put them on the round first. Oh my gosh. Put your top back on. I'm not. Gee. This is, sorry people if you think that's annoying, but gosh, respect the woman's privacy. Who knocked over my can? I heard that I was gonna drink that can. Sounds horrible. Damn. Wait, why is my fridge open? I don't wanna go near my fridge. Somebody's in my house. Here, I'm gonna be amazing, and I'm just gonna go close my fridge door, and someone's gonna pop up behind and say, yo, say hi to YouTube. This is my home. Huh?
There's someone here. There's someone in the apartment. The phone on the desk. I could call for help. The front door. It's the only way out. If I can reach it, I still have a chance.
I'm out. What do you think y'all trying to do? Hey! Take some of that! Are the two of you? Where'd you come from? Oh, wait. Pervert. Are there two of you? There are two of you! What are you trying to kill me for, man? No. bad, this is bad, this is bad, this is bad, this is bad. Three of them. Oh, well, that was certainly awkward right there. Trying to kill me. It's just hard because I can't do the thing fast. I can't do the left and over thing like super fast.
Church. All their children were gone. They searched and called for them. They cried and begged. But it was all to no avail. The children have never been seen again.
The parents come home from church. Okay, so they go home. All their children were gone, so they were missing out of the house. They searched and called for them. They cried and begged, but it was all to no avail. So they weren't ever seen. The children had never been seen again because they were in a different part of town. Okay. That makes more sense. Locker ticking? That's it. I have to go to that locker.
I have to get out of here and find out what this ticket is about.
I'm going out this way. That's nice, I can just hop the fence. Bye-bye. People don't know that I just left.
Gonna have to make it through the crowd. I can't take crowds. Just can't handle it.
I can't make it.
Too many people.
Jason!
Line 18, box number 3.
18, box number 3. 18, box number 3. 18, box number 3. Oh, wait.
Wrong locker.
What the? Oh, wait. 18. 18 is down here.
Wrong locker.
This is right down there. 18. Locker 1803. Right there. 1803. Where else am I supposed to go? Whatever locker it is, I'm lost. I'm lost to find him. Oh, wait. Origami. There was an origami that said, there was an origami that was a lizard, so what's Jason's origami? The box. What is this? Aren't these all the kid ones? There's the green lizard. Number 3, number 4, number 2. Does this have a clip? Oh, it's full. What? What is that? You're prepared to show courage to save your son. Joe's garage and parking lot were full. Are you prepared to show courage to save your son? To go to save someone you love. Five origami figures. Each figure is a trail. Each trail provides letters. The letters reveal an address. Okay, so each of them reveal an address. What is it with all these bonuses?
The killer is white. Age between 30 and 45. He doesn't act on impulse, but plans his crimes in a very meticulous fashion. He doesn't have anything personal against the victims. That's why he covers their faces with mud to make them anonymous.
Why does he kill them if he doesn't have anything against them?
For him, they're more of an image, a symbol. That's probably why he gives an origami figure and an orchid as gifts to apologize for what he's done to them.
Very interesting. And where does all that get us?
It builds up a profile of the killer and helps us understand the person we're looking for. It might have been useful if it was done earlier in this investigation.
Continue, Jaden.
One detail attracted my attention. The interval between the time when a victim disappears and the time when the body is found ranges from three to five days. But the rainfall is always six inches, give or take 10%.
What on earth does that mean?
All the victims are drowned in rainwater. The killer kills only in the fall when there is plenty of rain. It could be that he puts them in some sort of well or tank that is open to the skies and that fills up with rainwater. The more it rains, the less time the victim has to live. Then I studied the geographical distribution of the murders. Generally, a killer commits his first murder near to where he lives, so he has a safe place to flee to if any complications arise. The more confident he becomes, the further he roams from his base. By analyzing the locations where the victims disappeared, I was able to isolate a zone where the killer might live.
And what size is this zone?
For the moment, about 10 square miles.
Great. Must be 10,000 people live in that sort of area. You gonna question them one by one?
The more clues we get, the more we can reduce the zone. We can then cross-check it with our list of suspects and identify the killer.
So what's next?
There are two suspects whose psychological profile might fit and can be connected to the comfort zone. I'd like to question them.
Damn it. We're wasting our time with this bullshit. The killer's out there somewhere. We gotta get off our asses and find him.
Blake, I've had just about enough of your shit. You've been chasing this guy for what, 2 years? And what do you caught, huh? Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Well, you think you can do a better fucking job than me with your psychology degree and your great glasses? Well, let me tell you something, pal. That don't mean zip when it comes to getting out there. You're just a fucking bureaucrat.
I came here to find a killer. And that is exactly what I'm gonna do. With or without your help.
Fucking asshole!
That's enough!
said it took 6 inches of rainfall before the victim died. How much time do we have left?
If the weather forecasts are right, less than 72 hours. Answer. We waste our time coming here.
Maybe we should have a little look inside anyway.
There's nobody home.
There is now.
I'm not sure that's entirely legal.
Call the cops.
Looks like Nathaniel Williams is a pretty religious guy.
He's a God-fearing idiot, waiting for the end of the world. We questioned him a few months back because he was causing a disturbance in the park. He was ranting and raving. Said he heard voices. Had this idea in his sick little head that I was the Antichrist. I'd come to Earth to persecute him. Real twisted.
Candles are still lit. He should be back soon.
Pills everywhere, what in the world? Dirty dishes, rusty dishes. I don't think he's been back here in a while.
All the signs of a mystical obsessive neurosis compounded by a persecution complex. The guy's taking a break from reality, holed up here in this crazy apartment.
Good timing, Nathaniel. Just the man we're looking for.
Angels and ministers of grace defend us.
I'm Agent Norman Jaden, FBI. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
As God is my witness, I haven't done anything. I'm innocent.
Relax. Nobody's accusing you of anything. We just want to talk. Nathaniel, do you remember where you were last Tuesday at 4:30 p.m.?
Here? I was here. I was praying. All day.
Was there anybody with you?
No. No, I was alone.
Why all the crucifixes? You afraid of something?
The hour is nigh, and the wrath of God shall strike men down. I am preparing for the end of the world.
You were arrested in a case where a child disappeared from a park. What exactly happened?
I'm innocent. I have nothing to do with those murders. I was in the park because God spoke to me. I was arrested because I am the chosen one. That's all.
What about the voices, Nathaniel? Do you still hear the voices? We know who talks to you, don't we, Nathaniel? Or we both know who talks to you.
Don't speak that name.
Blake, what does he say
to you?
What
are you doing? I can't talk about it. You mustn't talk about it.
That's
enough. He orders
you to go and find
him
prey, doesn't he? He needs more and more.
No. No. You mustn't mention him. You'll bring him here.
He told you to go find that kid in the park.
Out of your mind?
The voices tormented you all night long. You wanted them to stop, didn't you, Nathaniel?
Stop! Stop! That's enough!
So you obeyed them to make them stop. You took that boy with you and you drowned him. Isn't that right?
No! Stop! Stop!
You killed them, didn't you, Nathaniel? Are you gonna confess, you bastard?
You are the Antichrist.
Put down the gun, Nathaniel.
I shall watch you to your father in hell. He is the son of Satan. He was sent to earth to destroy us. For Christ's sake, shoot!
Calm down, Nathaniel. Nobody here wants to hurt you. Put the gun down. Concentrate on my voice, Nathaniel. Listen only to my voice.
Team. You shall regret confronting the emissary of the Lord. You shall know divine power.
I'm here to help you, Nathaniel. To get rid of the voices in your head. But you have to trust me.
Christ, all powerful. Defend us in our battle with the forces of evil. Protect us from the cunning and wiles of the demon. May God Almighty manifest the power of His empire. And may divine power cast Satan and all the other spirits that prowl the world in search of souls into the darkest depths of hell.
Keep calm. Everything is going to be fine, Nathaniel. Back away, slowly. Now drop the gun. Drop it, Nathaniel. Put your hands on your head. Turn around. I shot him.
Yep. Looks like you did.
It was only a crucifix.
Can't say I'll miss him. Come on, let's go.
But if I haven't shot him, right, Josh? Oh. Oh. Oh my gosh, I feel so bad now. This is my house. This is my house. Hang on. Do it, shit. Put my... put my phone charger.
Mrs. Balls. Anybody home? Oh, Jesus. Wait a minute. Hello, little cutie. Oh, you looking for your mama?
I'll help that baby lift him, mama. Aw, oh, gee, Cookie. That's where I just came out of. She must be in the bedroom. Back here. You in here. Oh, this is he right here. Baby monitor.
Mrs. Bowles! Mrs. Bowles, are you there?
Bowles! Open the door! Now!
Oh, shit!
Oh!
Mrs. Balls! Mrs. Balls, can you hear me? Wake up! Wake up!
Bad person. Why can't I walk through the doorway?
I'm gonna call an ambulance.
No, I don't want to go to the hospital. Please.
Okay. You got something around here I can dress this wound with?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, don't move. I'll be right back.
Gosh, who did that to themselves? Why do I wash my hands? Let me walk again.
Let's see. I need this, and this, and this. I'm here for you, Susan. You'll be all right. I'll take care of you. Ah, I need more. Still bleeding. Stay with me, Susan. Susan, do you hear me? Susan, stay with me. Can you hear me? Not perfect, but it'll do. Care of the baby. okay?
Do you know what to do? With a baby, I mean.
I'm a private eye. There's nothing I can't do.
I can defend myself? I can pat someone.
Her name is Emily.
Okay.
Gotcha.
Let the baby stop crying. Hello, person. Welcome to my stream. Me, me, baby. Come here, me, baby. I have to go wash my hands. Again. I just washed them in the seat. I just washed them in the bathroom. Can't touch. Ooh, there's a baby bottle on me. This is some good hand washing motion. Dang, not over. Chill, baby, I'm coming. I am a good man.
Hi there, Emily.
But
so, what seems to be the problem, huh?
Oh, going by the smell,
I got a pretty good idea.
Look how gentle I am with this baby. Baby laugh.
Okay. How do you do this again?
Oh. Okay. Let's take the diaper. Are you a boy? It's a girl. I forgot about that. That's not how you do it. You're supposed to wipe your head. How do you do that?
No, brother, that's not the right way.
Okay.
Let's start again.
I cannot press, like, those three buttons.
There you go. Fresh new baby.
That's your rhythm.
Right, Emily? Mm-hmm.
The baby's cute.
Hey! What's the matter? I thought it was all wrong.
Oh, she needed the milk, yeah? She needed the milk, yeah? Of course she needed the milk, yeah?
I guess I better warm this thing up.
Oh, yeah. You're right. I guess I better. Well, I'm just gonna... Oh, is it done? It is done! I have your milk. Here you go. Here you go, baby, baby. Eh. Hey, what is wrong with my character?
Oh, Emily, are you hungry? Huh?
No, no.
Welcome to the stream, by the way.
Just tilt this bottle a little bit so you don't choke.
That baby just drank that milk. What in the world? That was so much milk. I had a baby once, apparently. There you go, I'll make you burp.
Oh, good job, Emily. Mm-hmm. You're feeling good now, right?
Now,
slow with that. I just been a butt and just went whoop-pow to the baby. Dipe. Ah, that's a dipe age. Oh, the baby's one? Aw. Better go check on Miss. Better go check on her. So she's not dead.
Thanks for looking after my baby. I didn't want to leave her. I just couldn't cope anymore.
Cope?
Jeremy. He was such a good boy. I can't understand why anyone would want to hurt him.
Do you take care of this baby on your own? Doesn't Jeremy's father live with you anymore?
He disappeared. The day after Jeremy. I don't know what happened to him.
Maybe he couldn't take it.
Ever since I've had to look up Emily all on my own and couldn't do it anymore.
I understand. Did your husband say anything before he disappeared? Did he leave a note or something?
No. He left the house without a word.
There was just a cell phone.
A cell phone?
Yeah, I found a cell phone in his dresser. I'm sure it wasn't his. I'd never seen it before. I tried to turn it on, but it didn't work.
Do you still have it?
Yeah, it's in a drawer. In the living room. You can have it if you like. I'm sure it's more use to you than to me.
Do you have any family or anybody to help you?
Yeah. My mother. I didn't want to ask her for anything. We don't really get along. But I guess I'm out of options.
Well, look after yourself. And Emily.
I will. I promise.
Time to go take a look at that drawer. Oh, please don't tell me. Okay, good. Here's the cell phone. Oh, it didn't work.
Good luck, Emily.
There we go. Reminder, move quickly the whole controller to the... What? You have to move the, like, I never moved it like that. Hey, I'm playing with Ethan now. Walking on the street like I own the place. Not like you work like I own the place. Okay, here we are. The part where... Okay. Here he is.
I can't stop thinking about that. Well, Sean's team is exhausted.
But at least he's alive. I'll do anything to get him out of there.
Excuse me?
Hey!
Oh! Hi. Sorry. Good to see you. What can I do you for?
I'd like to get my car.
Hey, you're a pretty patient guy, you are. That car's been there for 2 years. We took it out for a drive every month to check the tire's batteries, just like you said.
Here, it's the third floor down. Service elevators. Ah, oh, you have yourself a good one, Chief.
Oh, that guy's actually pretty nice to me. I thought he'd be the serial killer, though. So, I'll take the elevator. Bam! This is, third floor. Third floor down. Just so everybody knows, I suck at quick time events, but at least I don't die somehow. Somehow I don't. Oh. What? What? No. No way.
Your destination is 4 miles from here. Leave the parking lot and take the first right.
Okay. An amazing little smart car. Oh, no bonus? Okay, I understand, game. This game just doesn't like me. I have a bad feeling.
You have reached your destination.
What?
Are you ready to show your courage in order to save your son? Listen carefully. Take the highway and drive against the traffic for 5 miles. If you haven't reached your destination in 5 minutes, you will have me.
I can do it. I'd do anything to save my son. I don't want to die. Not here. Not like this. If I succeed, I'll get more letters from the hangar. It's my only need. No turning back now.
Do it!
I've got to do it, for Sean's sake. I have no choice.
Woo! 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 Woo!
Oh, come on!
back in this! Why did I take this? Why did I do this? For shot's sake! Oh, I thought it was a goner in there. Oh, I unlocked the bonus. Ha ha ha, game. Trophy earned, good driver. Thank you. I am a good driver. Well, not that much of a good driver, but at least I reached my destination. Crashing the car. Boy, you're the time I wear a man to be. Dude, I am amazing. Look at my character. I am a biker chick. Oh my gosh. His face is just...
What can I do for you?
I'd like a room.
For you? Anything. The only one in the register.
Did he eat his own poop in there, or what?
Manson, page 27. Single. How long will you be staying with us, Ms. Page?
I don't know yet.
Man, fine.
Room 201. Last floor stairs on the right in the courtyard.
Thanks.
What is this?
Pleasure was all mine.
That's for sure.
Oh my gosh, I got a stand on my booty. Can I go beat it up? I'm gonna go beat his Gucci up right now. I'm gonna go rip off this prize bottle. 201. 108. This is gonna be a long trip trying to find my room. Yeah, I probably have to go up like one more flight of stairs. Okay. Here's 209, so I gotta keep heading down. 211, what's this one? 209. So I gotta head this way. No? Right? 207, 205.
Sir? Are you alright? I'll call an ambulance.
No ambulance.
You're
bad.
You need a doctor.
Please, just help me to my room. It's number 207.
I just passed that. Okay, come on now. 207. And 207.
We got the key?
You
should see a doctor.
Must have maybe two broken ribs. It's not fatal. but it's sore as hell.
Your head is bleeding. It looks deep.
Really? You don't have jack crap.
I should just disinfect his cuts.
Oh, that's good. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna go do that right now. I'm gonna go disinfect his cut.
I'm gonna disinfect your wound. This might hurt a little. Sorry. Are you okay? There. At least we won't get infected.
Thanks.
Oh,
Paracomal painkiller. Administer in cases of intense pain. Do not take more than one pill every 24 hours.
Here. Take this. It should do some good. It's a painkiller. It'll help reduce the pain. It says on the box to take one every 24 hours. I don't think it's a good idea to exceed the dose.
I can't afford to wait.
I would move around for a few days if I were you.
I'm gonna take a shower.
Alright. Let me help you.
This man is badly wounded. Can't believe the car crashed.
I'll wait here until you come out. Let me know if you need anything.
Anything. Someone's watching me.
Talk to me. That way I'll know if you pass out.
What's your name?
Madison.
Are you staying in the hotel?
No, I live in town. I suffer from chronic insomnia. I seem to only be able to sleep in motels. Don't ask me why. Whenever I get too exhausted, I come and spend the night here.
I'm just passing through. And what else do you do, Madison? Apart from fixing up strangers.
I'm a photographer. I take pictures of furniture for fashionable design magazines. And you?
I'm an architect.
Thanks for staying. I feel a lot better now.
Okay. I better get going then. By the way, you never told me your name.
Ethan.
Be careful, Ethan.
Wait a minute. That's what my wife said. Now I must
continue the search for my boy, Sean. I must.
Are you prepared to suffer to save your son? The old power plant on Anchored Street. He doesn't reminder, press his touchpad X. I like how he doesn't bother to go and take all the origami, so after he's done with that one thing he can go to the X location. I'm making Assassin's Creed Origin videos, so be prepared for that, people. Just to let you know. Sorry that I did that.
Was that the first time?
Sorry?
First time you killed somebody.
It always does something to you the first time. Then you get used to it.
I'm not sure I want to get used to it. That's him.
Oh, it's him. It's him. It's the one. Oh, yeah. Oh, wait a minute. Is that the guy that we beat up that one?
You're Porta?
Yeah.
Lieutenant Carter Blake, I'd like to ask you some questions. This time it looks like we got our origami killer.
Yes, our origami killer. Oh my gosh, that was. No, I want the light back on. Probably. I'm gonna stick this door. Let's grab my axe.
aspirin thing. We just. That's labeled fridge. Let's not sit on the couch. Let's go through the door right here. Ah, beautiful in here. Let's see what's in here.
You said I could contact you if I remembered anything. Can I come in?
Sure. You want a drink?
Yes, glass of water, please.
Take a seat, I'll get it.
Get that glass of water for you. I mean, here's the glass, and then there's the water. A glass of water. Yeah. Can I drink it in front of her? Here you go.
Thanks. I just remembered something. Maybe it's not important. But a letter arrived in the mail the morning Johnny disappeared.
A letter? What kind of a letter?
It was addressed to Johnny's father. I don't know what was inside it, but he read it and then he left. That's the last time I saw him.
And you think there's a connection between that letter and Johnny's death, is that it? Do you remember anything else about the letter?
Well, I don't know why, but I kept the envelope.
Nothing particular. Except the address.
The address?
It was typed with an old typewriter. Could be a lead, you never know. Well, thanks for your help, Lauren. I'll let you know if it leads to anything.
Wait, I can't just sit around and do nothing while you're out there looking for the man who killed my son. Ever since you came around, I've been thinking, and I want to come with you. Help you in your investigation?
There's nothing you can do to help, Lauren. It's not a good idea. Believe me.
If you won't let me help you, I'm keeping the envelope. It's all or nothing.
Listen, an investigation like this is dangerous. And I don't have time to play the bodyguard.
How many clues have you got, Mr. Shelby? This envelope. Maybe your only link to the killer. I understand. It was a stupid idea. Sorry for wasting your time, Mr. Shelby.
Wait. You're really something special, Lauren. I'll give you that.
I'm just a mother. A mother who wants to find out who killed her son. Are we partners?
We're partners. Maybe you better stay in the car.
We're partners, remember? Wherever you go, I go.
I like her as my partner. I like having a partner. It's pretty fun.
What are we doing here?
We come to see Gordy Kramer.
Kramer? The bigwig tycoon from Kramer Construction?
No, his son.
You think maybe he's the origami killer?
For now, I just have a few questions that need answers.
This seems a little fishy right now. Yeah, definitely fishy.
Kramer's decor another time.
Are we gonna be here long? This place gives me the creeps.
I'm gonna go find Gordy Kramer. You stay here till I come back. Okay?
Okay. That's just let me know if you need me.
Pretty lonely right there.
Gordy.
Hi, I'd like to see Gordy.
Gordy hasn't seen anyone. Beat it.
Look, here's Mr. Franklin. Says I should go up.
You talk so crazy if I shove that wand down your throat? Beat it. I ain't for sale.
If I want to see Gordy Kramer, I'm going to have to go about it some other way.
So, did you find Gordy?
He's upstairs. He got two goons blocking the way.
Do you want me to handle them?
Hey, what are you going to do? Knock him out with a pair of high heels?
Leave it to me! Just be ready to go as soon as they leave the stairs!
Wait, Lord!
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Origami Killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Why are those... Oh.
I'd like to know exactly what happened to little Joseph Brown.
Beat it! You hear me? Get the hell out of here!
What do you want?
A witness saw little Joseph Brown get in the back of your limousine. That was the last time anybody ever saw him. Now, I know you've been arrested and interrogated until your father made a little phone call and the file was closed. I'd like to hear your version of the facts.
The kid was lost. I just offered to drive him home. The police arrived, I explained the misunderstanding, and I was released. End of story. Nothing to get excited about, right?
I don't know why, but your story just doesn't check out. You're giving me the crap now. Tell me something I can't believe.
Very well. I'm the Origami Killer. I get my victims into my car. I drown them in rainwater. Then I dump them on a wasteland with an origami figure in one hand and an orchid on the chest. I do that because I'm bored, Mr. Shelby. And it's a creative and entertaining way of having fun. Is that good enough for you? Or do you want more? This interview is over.
Get rid of this clown!
It's a dangerous game you're playing, Kramer.
Do you know who my father is? He only has to lift one finger and you won't wake up tomorrow morning. You're the one that should be afraid, Mr. Shelby. Not me.
He's not the origami killer. He's lying. No way. He sounded a little skeptical. He probably just heard the news. Probably just heard the news and then just acted like that.
And then they're all like, yeah, sure. That ends it for today, people. I'll see y'all in the next video I make of this. See ya.